Hallelujah.
Nasema hallelujah.
Declare with me my life.
Tangaza nami maisha yangu.
Will never.
Hayatabaki.
Ever.
Kamwe.
Be the same again.
Kuwa sawa tena.
In Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Do you believe it?
Je, unaamini?
Do you believe it?
Je, unaamini?
One more time declare, and my life.
Sema maisha yangu.
Will never.
Hayatawai.
Ever.
Kamwe.
Be the same again.
Baki kuwa sawa tena.
In Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Amen.
Amina.
If you believe it,
kama unaamini wewe,
look for two people.
Tafuta watu wawili.
Give them a high five.
Wasalimie.
Tell them you are my witness.
Waambie wewe ni shahidi wewe.
And let us be seated in Jesus' name.
Na tuketi kwa jina la Yesu.
I did not come alone.
Sikuja peke yangu.
I came with Mama Joy Senior.
Nikuja na Mama Joy mkubwa.
That one is Mama Joy Junior.
Ule ni Mama Joy mdogo.
Because our Joy is older than their Joy.
Sababu Joy wetu ni mkubwa kuliko Joy wao.
Their Joy is 35 years old.
Joy wetu ni miaka 35.
Joy wao, Joy wao.
Joy wao ni miaka 35.
Our Joy is 42 years old.
Joy wao ni wetu ni 42 miaka.
So you can see we are senior.
Basi sisi ni wakubwa wao.
Acha Mama Joy Senior alete pongezi.
Aha.
Bwana asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
And I want to congratulate.
Nataka niwatie motisha.
First of all, our covenant.
Basi hawa wenzetu.
Brother and sister.
Katika ndugu na dada.
And the whole of this church.
Na kanisa hili lote.
For what the Lord has done.
Kwa yale Mungu ametenda.
When I was just sitting there.
Nilipokuwa nimeketi mahali pale.
And thinking of the many 35 years God has brought you through.
Nilifikiria miaka yote Mungu amewaleta.
I just felt very humbled.
Niko basi nimewekwa kutulia.
And I thank God for you people.
Nawashukuru basi nyinyi.
For obeying the Lord.
Kumtii Mungu.
If they did not obey the calling of God.
Kama wangetii mwito wa Mungu.
To have that humble beginning.
Kuwa basi na huo mwanzo.
All of you won't be here.
Hatungekuwa hapa sisi sote.
So can we celebrate them?
Basi tuwashukuru tena.
Celebrate them.
Tuwashangilie.
Amen.
Amina.
Because the Lord spoke to them.
Maana Mungu aliwanenea.
And they came.
Na wakaja.
There was nothing.
Hapakuwa na chochote kile.
I was there at that time.
Nilikuwa hapa wakati huo.
There was nothing.
Hapakuwa na kitu.
But we can see what God has done.
Lakini tazama Mungu ametenda.
So I celebrate you.
Basi nawashangilia.
For standing with them.
Kusimama na wao.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For your giving.
Kwa kutoa kwenu.
Your faithfulness.
Kwa kuwa na imani kwenu.
For praying for them.
Na kwa waombea.
For ministering to them.
Na kwa hudumia.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord bless you.
Wacha Mungu awabariki.
35 years.
Miaka 35.
Is a 35 year old man.
Ni mtu wa miaka 35 huyo.
Isn't it?
Aha.
A 35 year old man, I don't expect them to be in their parents' house.
Mtu mzima fai kuwa na kuwa kwao miaka 35 kama hiyo.
So today.
Basi kwao,
as we celebrate, actually I'm asking the Lord,
basi namuuliza Mungu,
what next?
Nini tena?
After 35 years.
Nini baada ya miaka 35?
These people maybe have about how many years to live?
Pengine they will live wana miaka
mingapi? Beyond 100.
Watakaa zaidi ya miaka 100.
But you don't want them to keep ministering to you.
Utaki basi wao kuwahudumia tu.
For the rest of their lives.
Kwa miaka yao yote.
There must have been children.
Lazima kuwe na wana.
Have been born in this house.
Wamezaliwa hapa.
Raised in this house.
Wamekuwa hapa.
And they are ready.
Na wako tayari.
To do wonders for God.
Kufanya maajabu kwa Mungu.
So if you are 35.
Kama uko miaka 35.
You are already late.
Wewe umechelewa.
If you have not discovered.
Kama hujagundua.
What the Lord wants you to do.
Ile Mungu anataka ufanye.
In this house.
Katika nyumba hii.
My prayer for you.
Ombi langu kwako.
That the next 35 years.
Miaka mingine inayokuja 35.
You will do more than your parents have done.
Utafanya zaidi kuliko wazazi walivyofanya.
Far above what they have done.
Zaidi ale waliotenda.
So kazi ni kwenu.
Basi the job is on you.
May the Lord bless you.
Wacha Mungu awabariki.
We love you.
Tunawapenda.
We are happy to be here.
Tunafurahi kuwa hapa.
And your joy is our joy.
Na basi ufurahi wako
ni furaha yetu. When you rejoice,
we rejoice. Na tunaita tukishangilia mashangilio.
When you cry, we cry.
Ukilia tunalia.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is how much we are connected to this.
Hivi basi ndio tumejiunga pamoja nanyi.
May the Lord bless you.
Wacha Mungu awabariki.
And I know tonight as we close this conference.
Najua leo tufunga kongamano hili.
The Lord has a word for each
Mungu
one of us.
Mungu ana neno kwenu.
To send us to the next 35 years. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Sante.
God bless you. May the grace uh, Praise the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana libarikiwe.
Bwana asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
Eh, Bwana asifiwe.
Praise the Lord.
I know it's raining outside, but this Deliverance Church, Kasarani Zimmerman.
Kasarani,
am I correct?
Amina.
I say this Deliverance Church International, Kasarani Zimmerman. Am I correct?
Jenikosawa.
Can I hear an amen?
Wachanisikia amina.
Can I hear a praise the Lord?
Wachanisikia Bwana asifiwe.
Can someone give the Lord a hand clap offering in this
house?
Can somebody make a joyful noise to the Lord in this house? The devil is alive. Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
Tomorrow is a working day.
Kesho ni siku ya kazi.
Because it's Sunday.
Ni Jumapili.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Praise the Lord.
And now you are 35 years.
Basi kama una miaka 35.
You also turned 35 in May.
Ujafika basi May.
In May we turned 35.
Sisi tulifika miaka 35 mwezi wa May.
And in November you have turned 35.
Tulifika 35 mwezi huu wa November nyinyi.
We have come to congratulate you.
Kuja kuwatia pongezi.
And celebrate with you.
Na tushangilie nanyi.
In the name of the Lord.
Kwa jina la Bwana.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
We are in a time of transition.
Tunabasi katika hali ya kugeuka.
Because next year.
Maana mwaka ujao.
The entire Deliverance Church.
Kanisa zima la Deliverance.
Will be celebrating 50 years.
Tushangilie miaka 50.
And imagine. We shall be in Kasarani here. You don't have to go far. Some of us have to come from Umoja.
Kule Umoja.
With you, you just have to cross the road.
Barabara tu.
So you need to be very many there.
Jae pale.
Amen.
Amina.
I say amen.
Amina.
In the book of, I want to bring a short word.
Fupi.
So that I can encourage you and strengthen you.
Nguvu.
And encourage my brother.
Na nguvu ndugu
and strengthen my brother.
Na nguvu ndugu
and my sister.
Na pia.
Somebody say amen.
Mdu sema amina.
In the book of Genesis.
Kitabu cha Mwanzo.
Chapter 11.
Sura ya moja.
And verse 30.
Wa 30.
31.
Na moja.
And 32.
Na 32.
We have these words.
Hili.
What does it say? Read for me. What does it
say?
You know me, I'm a Bible teacher. I want to read scripture. What does it say?
Inasema nini?
I didn't say you whisper. What does it say?
Inasema nini basi usinongoneze.
But Sarai was.
Alikuwa tasa.
And she had no.
Hakuwa na mwana.
I've come to tell somebody here.
Kuja kuambia mtu hapa.
Your season.
Wakati wako.
You're not on this side.
Ijakuwa wakati
huu. I said your season.
Basi msimu wako.
Of being barren
tasa,
and without a child
na bila mwana,
is about to come to an end
mwisho,
to the glory of God.
Wa Mungu.
Somebody say amen.
Sema amina.
They were dwelling in a land
mji,
where Sarai was barren
Sarai tasa,
and she had no child.
Na hakuwa na mwana.
And because they were there,
maana pale,
verse 31 says,
nasema,
her father-in-law was called Terah. Say with me, Terah.
Sema na mimi Terah.
Again, say Terah.
Sema Terah.
What does it say?
Inasema nini?
And Terah, you're reading with you. What does it say?
Tusome.
And Terah
Basi
took
Terah.
His son Abram
mm-hmm.
and his grandson Lot, the
Lot.
Son of Haran, and his daughter-in-law Sarai, his son Abram's wife. And they went out with them from Ur of the Chaldeans to go to the land of?
Canaan.
To go to the land of? So where were they going?
Wapi?
I'm asking you, where were they going? So they left where they were living, where Sarai was barren, where Sarai had no child, and they said there is a land called Canaan. Let me preach on this side. They said there is another land. It's called Canaan. This Canaan did not become discovered in Exodus. Even in Genesis, Canaan was a place of plenty. Am I talking to somebody here? A land flowing with milk and honey. So they said we shall leave this city where we are barren. We are going to a place of increase and multiplication. The land of Canaan.
Mji wa Kanani.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
I pray even if you are 35.
Naomba kama miaka 35 wewe.
May God give you an ambition.
Wacha Mungu akupatie mwanzo.
I say may God give you an ambition.
Wacha Mungu akupatie juu.
Refuse to settle where you are.
Kama ukulia mahali ulipo.
There's still more land for you to conquer.
Kuna mahali pa kwenda.
There are still places for you to take charge.
Kuna mahali uchukue.
There are still territories for you to bring under the kingdom.
Kuna ngome uweke chini ya.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
But look at that verse. Let's finish that
hilo.
What does it say?
Look at it.
What does it say?
Yasemaje?
And put up the verse, not me. What does it say?
Yes, imagine.
And they came. You are reading with me.
Tusome pamoja.
And they came to What did they do? And they dwelt there. Look at the verse 32.
Yes,
we'll finish with that one.
What
does this say? So the days of Terah were 205 years. And what happened? Terah died. Terah died in. But where were they going? But Terah died where? Did he get to Canaan? Where did he die? Before getting to, but I've come to declare to you, in the name of Jesus, you shall not die on the way. I said, you shall not die on the way. The reason I can say that confidently, Bishop Jimmy Kemani, it is because in this same story of three verses, even, no, sio nyimbo, vifungu vitatu, eh?
Vifungu vitatu, kunradhi.
Okay. Yes. Where did nyimbo tatu come from? In this same story,
katika story hii,
of three verses,
katika andiko tatu,
there are people
kunao watu,
who left Ur of the Chaldeans together with Terah.
Walitoka Ur pamoja na Terah.
Even though Terah died in Haran,
atakaba alikufa pale Harani,
their people did not die.
Watu wake hawakufa.
Abraham and Sarah,
na Sarai,
they made it to Canaan.
Walifika pale Kanani.
And I've come to declare,
nimekuja kutangazia,
if Abraham,
kama Abrahamu,
where are you?
Muko wapi?
I say if Abraham
Abrahamu,
and Sarah
na Sarai,
were able to make it
walifika,
to Canaan
Kanani,
in the name of Jesus,
kwa jina la Yesu,
I've come to declare to you also,
kutangazia pia
wewe, you shall not die on the way.
Hufi njiani,
you shall get there.
Utafika pale.
Tell them for me, neighbor,
tembe jirani,
you shall get there.
Utafika hapo.
That's the title of my message. If you're wondering what the title is you shall get there. Tell somebody you shall get there. Mwambie utatoboa.
Utafika.
Look at the other one. Tell them utafika.
Mwambie you will arrive.
Somebody say amen.
Sema amina.
If Abraham got there, you shall get there.
Abraham alifika, basi
if Sarai got there, you shall get there.
Alifika, pewe,
even Lot was able to get there.
Ataleto alifika, pia Loto.
That's what I'm declaring to you.
Kutangazia, pewe,
in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yesu Christo,
even though Terah died,
kama Terah alikufa,
you shall not die.
Hufi.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Kwa jina la Yesu Christo,
you shall get there in Jesus'
utafika
name.
Pale kwa jina la Yesu.
Tell your neighbor,
mbe jirani, mbe jirani,
you shall get there.
Utafika kule.
If they are not talking to you,
kama
you tell him with a swag.
Mwambie basi na swaga.
I
mimi
shall
nita
get
fika
there
kule
in Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
You may think I'm preaching yet I'm finishing. I came to confirm Bishop Jimmy Kimani. Whatever vision God has given you, whatever dream you have in your heart, when you went to Merema Drive 35 years ago, in the name of Jesus Christ, you shall get there. I came to tell a family in this house. I came to tell an individual in this house. Whatever dream God has given you, whatever vision God has given you, you shall get there in Jesus' name. The devil is a liar. You shall not die prematurely. You shall not die on the way. You shall not die before you get there. Because I have come to declare. You shall get.
Utafika.
You shall get.
Utafika.
You shall get.
Utafika.
I told you may think I'm preaching yet I'm finishing. John Austin, Joel Austin's father.
Yes,
Johanna. John Austin.
Johanna.
Asema John Austin.
John Austin.
The father of Joel Austin.
Baba yake Joel Austin.
Used to say.
Alikuwa akisema.
For every child of God.
Kwa kila mwana wa Mungu.
There is a place called there.
Kunae mahali paitwa kule.
I said for every child of God.
Kwa kila mwana wa Mungu.
There is a place called.
Kuna pahali panaitwa.
So in God today, in Christ Jesus today, for this church, there is a place called there. For your family, there is a place called there. For you individually, there is a place called there. And I've been sent to tell you, in the name of Jesus Christ, you shall get there. In the book of Philippians chapter 3 from verse 12, Paul says, I do not consider myself as though I've already gotten there. But this one thing I do. I'm forgetting those things which are behind. And I am pressing on Kaunda. Are you in the right church here? But I am pressing onwards towards the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus, that I may be able to hold that for which I was laid hold of. There is a reason God laid hold for you. And today, in the name of Jesus, I've come to encourage you. You are not in this church by accident. You are not alive by accident. You are not in this service by accident. You are not living in this generation by accident. And I've come to encourage you, friend. You shall get there in Jesus' name. Reach for me, tell your neighbor one more time. Neighbor, there is a place called there in Christ Jesus for you and for me. And I assure you, you shall get there.
Utafika kule.
I can even say the grace now and we go home. Because I've delivered my message. You shall get.
Utafika.
You shall get.
Utafika.
You shall get.
Utafika.
As a business, you shall get. As a family, you shall get. As an individual, you shall get. As a church, you shall get. The devil could have killed terror in Haran. But he shall not kill you. Where you are. Hauja korogewa.
Uwezi korogewa.
Nimesema hauja korogewa.
You won't be korogewad.
Somebody say amen.
Sema amina.
I said somebody say amen.
Sema amina.
You must understand.
You lazima uelewe.
One of the reasons.
Moja sababu.
Terror did not get there. It is because the there he was pursuing. The there he was pursuing was not his there. It was actually Abraham's there. In Genesis chapter 12, verse
1,
the Bible says, and the Lord had said to Abraham. So, whom did God talk to? I'm asking, whom did God talk to? What did he tell him? Get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house to a land that I will. So, Terah was pursuing a there that was not his. That's why I'm praying for you. Now in the midst of this service. Are you understanding me, friends? Don't pursue there that belongs to somebody else. There is a there that is for you. And I am praying tonight in the name of Jesus that God may show you are there so that you can pursue you are there. Bump your neighbor again, wake them up. Tell him, neighbor, don't come to my there. There is a there for you. May God show you are there. I pray for someone in this house. May God show you are there. I say, may God show you are there. So you shall pursue you are there. Kuna watu wanafuata there mtu mwingine alafu anakufia njiani. Because it was never you are there. That's why you will die before getting there. Because it's not you are there. Especially we Africans. We like asking people, and where are you going? And then he start following. I'm also coming. From today, stop. From today, I allow you. May God open your eyes. May God give you revelation. This side they are not receiving. Can I pray for you on this side? I say, may God open your eyes. May God give you revelation. May God give you discernment of what you are there is. And when you know it, may you go for it in the name of Jesus. And I assure you, If it is there in God, you shall get there.
Utafika wewe.
The beautiful thing is this. He told Abraham, you go to a place that I will show you. I'm going to save you money now.
Na ukua pesa zeko.
You don't need to pay a preacher any money to tell you are there. Because when you get there, you yourself, this side, I said when you get there, you yourself will know I am there. It is between you and God. So you don't need anybody to tell you that is you are there. When you get there, Millicent, nobody needs to tell you. You yourself shall know I am there. Let me try on this side.
They were
a bit hard when I was preaching in this corner. I was saying, I'm trying to save you money. Because some of you have a habit of sending preachers money to tell you you are there. I've come to assure you, God has said, you leave. Start going. When you get there, I will show you. Nobody else knows you are there. It is you who shall know. I am there. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? If you don't know you are there, nobody else knows it. I'm in Genesis 22. Give me that in the NIV. You may think I'm preaching yet I'm finishing. Genesis 22. From verse 1. Read it for me. I thought we were reading together. Sometimes later, God tested Abraham. And he said to him, Abraham, what did he say? Here I am. He replied. Verse 2. Then God said, take your son, your only son, whom you love, Isaac, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him where? Yeah. Sacrifice him where?
Wapi.
As a burnt offering. On a mountain I will? He doesn't know, but he's called, it's a place called? Yeah. Go to verse 3. What does it say?
Yes, imagine.
Early in the next morning, Abraham got up early, loaded his donkey. He took with him two of his servants and his son Isaac. When he had cut enough food for the burnt offering, he set out for the place God had told him about. There is a place God has put in your heart. Nobody else knows it. You know it yourself. Today I just came to encourage you that you shall get to that place. Look at verse 4. How does it begin? On the third day, Abraham looked up and he saw the place in there and he knew that's the place. On the third, when he lifted up his eyes, he saw and he knew. I'm talking to somebody. They are not again on this side. I'm talking to somebody. Tonight shall be your third day. You shall lift up your eyes. You shall see the place. You shall know that is the place. Nobody shall tell you. You shall not pay any money. Nobody shall lay hands on you. You yourself shall know that is the place. And I've come to declare, you shall get. You shall get. Saw it. And he said, you know what? That is the place. Nobody told him. God put it in his heart. I pray for you. May the God who showed you where you are supposed to go, how your business is supposed to go, how your family is supposed to go, what your children are supposed to become, what is this church is supposed to become, that God has sent me to assure you, you shall get there in Jesus' name. Look at the following verse. Now Abraham begins to talk. What does he say? And you're reading with me? He said to his servants, what did he tell them? Stay here with the donkey while I and the boy go where? Go where? Go where? When it comes to a place called there, a father only goes with his son.
Baba huenda na mwanawe tu.
Stay here.
Baki hapa.
With the donkeys. While I and the boy go
mimi
there. We will worship, then we'll come back to you. And we shall stay in a place called where?
Here. Wapi?
Bump your neighbor.
Mambie jirani.
Tell him, neighbor, if you are not going there, you shall remain here. The danger is this. You are coming, you are preaching, tell him the danger is this. When you stay here, you'll stay with the donkeys. That is the danger. That is the danger of not getting there. You will either die like
terror
or remain with the donkeys like the servants. I declare. I declare. You are not a donkey keeping material. I said you are not a donkey keeping material. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever could have happened before this service, after this service, I've come to assure you, you are not keeping the donkeys again. You are getting there with the Father. You are getting there in the name of Jesus. Somebody say amen. Touch to go tell a neighbor. I told you, I shall get there. Now I know I'm getting there. In the name of Jesus, I am getting. I am getting. They leave the donkeys and the servants and they start climbing. And some drama begins to happen. Because Isaac notices something. I'm in verse 6, whoever is on the computer. I'm in verse
6.
Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering. And he placed it on his son. And he himself carried the fire and the knife as the two of them went together. This is another lesson for another day. But I'll not charge you.
Lakini,
let me throw it at you. Sons need to walk with their father. But many sons don't want to walk with their father.
Lakini,
because the father is always carrying the knife and the fire.
Huwa na kisu na moto saa zote.
That's why many sons run away from fathers. You want to walk alone. Because when you look at the father,
baba,
he has a knife
kisu,
and he has fire.
Na anamoto,
and the son
na ule mwana,
is carrying firewood.
Basi kuni.
I pray
Na kuombea.
If you are a son in this house,
kama wewe ni mwana wa jumba hili,
stay.
Baki.
The knife this father is carrying,
kile kisu baba anachobeba,
and the fire is carrying,
na ule moto anaobeba,
is not to kill you.
Utakuwa.
Sio ya kukuua.
Sio ya kukuua.
Is for pruning.
Ni ya kukurekebisha.
If you see a farmer going with a knife in his coffee plantation,
ukiona basi mkulima akiwa na kisu katika shamba lake la kahawa,
he's not to cut down the coffee trees.
Ameenda kukata miti ya kahawa.
He's to prune them.
Ameenda kuitengeneza tu ile sawa.
And Jesus says,
Yesu akasema,
every branch that bears fruit,
unaweza ama tu,
I prune
na utengeneza,
so that it can bear more.
Ili uzae mwingi.
That's why a father carries a knife.
Kwa maana baba utembea na kisu.
And he carries fire.
Na ana moto.
It's for pruning the sons.
Ni ya kutengeneza ule mwanae.
That's not, it was not part of my message. I'm giving you, that one I'm giving you for free. You don't pay for it. Isaac says, go back, go on to the next verse. Quickly. Then Isaac spoke. And he said to his father Abraham,
Daddy,
yes, my son. The fire and the wood are here. I see, I'm carrying the wood. You are carrying fire. You are carrying the knife. But where is the lamb for the burnt offering?
Lakini hile tunemchinja yu wapi?
Kondoo wa dhabihu yuko wapi?
Kondoo wa dhabihu yuko wapi kunradhi?
Abraham answered.
Abraham mwanangu.
In the next verse.
Mstari unaofuata.
God himself.
Mungu mwenyewe.
Will provide a lamb for the burnt offering, my son.
Ataleta hiyo dhabihu ya mwenyewe.
And the two of them went together.
Mambo wawili tena pamoja.
You must understand.
Lazima uelewe.
As Abraham,
kama Abrahamu,
and Isaac,
na Isaka,
were climbing the mountain,
walikuwa wanapanda mlima,
from this side,
kutoka upande
huo, going to a place called there,
kwenda mahali paitwako there,
from the other side,
katika upande mwingine,
the angel of the living God,
malaika wa Mungu,
was climbing with the lamb,
alikuwa anapanda na kondoo,
to go and meet them,
kwenda
kuwakutanisha, not where the donkeys are,
pale pale kwa,
but at a place called there,
mahali paitwako there,
there is a place,
kuna mahali,
unless you get there,
lazima ufike pale.
Let me close this message. You are not getting it.
Jumbihi.
I said there is a place.
Kuna mahali,
when you get there,
pale,
it's a place of satisfaction. They are not getting me. I said there is a place.
Kuna pahali,
when you get there,
pale,
it's a place of satisfaction. A place of fulfillment. A place of your provision. A place of your destiny. A place of entering a covenant with God in a new way. But you cannot get into that place when you're still with the donkeys. You must go to a place called there, and you shall find God waiting for you with your provision, with your blessing, with your victory, with your fulfillment. Somebody say yes. There are some things in God you shall never receive until you get to that place called
there.
Elijah prophesied himself into trouble. He had no wife, no family, and he still stands up. And he stood up.
Akasimama juu.
And he said, as long as the Lord lives,
akasema mradi basi Mungu anaishi,
and I live,
na ninapoishi,
there shall be no rain,
hakutakuwa na mvua,
for 3.5 years,
kwa miaka 3.5,
until I say so.
Hata paka niseme mimi mwenyewe.
And the man has no house.
Jamaa hakuwa na nyumba huyo.
He has no family.
Hana jamii.
He has no farm.
Hana hata shamba.
And he prophesies himself into trouble.
Na anatabiri yeye mwenyewe katika shida.
Then God speaks.
Mungu akanena.
And he tells Elijah.
Akasema Elia.
Elijah.
Elia.
Get thee out of here.
Toka hapa.
Go to the brook called Cherith.
Nena mahali paitwa Cherith.
And stay.
Naishi.
And stay.
Na ubaki.
Why?
Kwa nini?
For there.
Mahana pale.
I have commanded.
Nimeamuru.
You are not getting me.
Hawapati.
For there.
Mahana pale.
I have commanded the ravens to feed.
Nimeamuru basi kunguru wakulishe.
If Elijah went to a big river,
kama Ali alienda katika,
he would have missed his provision.
Angekosa ile matoleo.
But he had to obey God.
Lakini alimtii Mungu.
And go to a place called,
akaenda mahali paitwa there.
Because his provision was in a place called,
maana wakati alikuwa mahali pale.
After a few months,
baada ya miezi kadhaa,
the brook dried. God came again and told him, Elijah, the brook is dry. Listen to what I'm going to say now. Because you must understand this. Are you ready for revelation? Or just like people laying hands on you, falling on the ground? Me, I'll not make you fall. I'll give you truth from the Word of God. Are you ready for it? Or you want me to lay hands on you? You want to know the truth? The truth will set you free. Can I teach you? For a season. Kwa majira fulani. The brook Cherith.
Ikageuka.
Kijito cha Cherith.
Kijito cha Cherry.
Don't go ahead of me. I'm the preacher. You know, okay, you are my interpreter.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sorry.
The brook called Cherith.
Kijito cha Cherry.
Was the place called there?
Ilikuwa pale paitwa there.
For Elijah.
Kwa Elia.
But it dried.
Lakini ikakauka.
You are there today.
Dea yako leo.
Shall not be there in a 3 years time.
Haitakuwa there kwa miaka mitatu.
And when the brook dried, God tells Elijah, don't stay here. This is now history. Rise up. Go to Zarephath. Because there, I've commanded a widow to feed you there. There are some people in this house. You are still staying in a place that was there for yesterday. Tonight I've come to pray in the name of Jesus Christ. May God give you a revelation for a new there for you. Come on, shake your neighbor, tell him, neighbor, if what was there yesterday it has become dry, don't you die there. Rise up right here and start going to another place. Because always in God, in every season, there is a new place called there for you. Don't you die when you are there for yesterday has become here. And tonight, in the name of Jesus, I am praying to the Father. Where are you? I say I'm praying to the Father to open your eyes to see another there, so you don't keep on staying in that place that is no longer fruitful, it's no longer working, it's no longer helping you, it's no longer fulfilling you. Push your neighbor, tell him, neighbor, get out. Abraham, Elijah,
Elia,
Isaac,
Isaka,
when they got there,
na walifika pale,
they found provision.
Walipata basi matoleo yao.
They found fulfillment.
Walipata kutimiziwa.
They found restoration.
Walipata basi kurudishiwa.
They found the power of God.
Walipata nguvu za Mungu.
They entered a new covenant with God.
Walikuwa na agano lipya na Mungu.
That is why the meaning of a place called there.
Hiyo ndio maana ya mahali paitwako there.
The reason why Terah died in Haran.
The other reason.
It's because when they got to Haran,
Harani,
the Bible says,
bile nasema,
they dwelt
walibaki
there.
Walisalia pale.
Walika
pale.
There are places in life
kuna pahali katika maisha,
you are not supposed to dwell.
Haufai basi kubakia.
You are only supposed to pass through.
Unafaa kupita tu.
One of them is the valley of the shadow of death. Bonde la uvuli wa mauti.
Bonde la uvuli wa mauti, asante.
David says,
Daudi kasema,
because the Lord is my shepherd,
maana Mungu ni mchungaji wangu,
there is a place he's taking me.
Kuna mahali ananipeleka.
And in this journey,
na katika safari hii,
as I go there,
kama naenda pale,
I shall find myself
nitajipata mwenyewe
in the valley of the shadow of death.
Katika bonde la uvuli wa mauti.
I refuse,
ninakataa,
to dwell there.
Kubakia pale.
That's why he says,
ndio maana akasema,
I shall pass through.
Nitapita.
The valley of the shadow of death. Because that is not where I'm supposed to stay. Because there is a place I'm supposed to dwell. It is called the house of the Lord. He said, I shall dwell in the house of the Lord. Because in the house of the Lord, my head is anointed with oil. They are not getting my revelation. Their revelation level just can I preach on this side? Can I preach on this side? Because in the house of the Lord, my head has been anointed with oil. And the level of my anointing is manifested in my cup. My cup is running over. The level of my anointing is manifested in my table. God has laid a table before me in the presence of my enemies. They cannot stop me from eating from this table when I come to my dwelling place. I'm talking to somebody here. Where are you? I said, where are you? The devil is a liar. Talk to your neighbor, tell him, neighbor, I refuse to stay. I refuse to die where I am right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank God for 35 years. Today I've come to push you on for another 35 years.
Amen.
I said I thank God for 35 years. But tonight I've come to push you on. There's another 35 years. And I came to prophesy. You shall get there. I say you shall get there. I say you shall get there. Somebody say amen. Tell your neighbor. Thank God for 35 years. I look forward to another 35 years. And I shall get there.
Nitafika.
I shall get.
Nitafika.
I shall get.
Nitafika.
I thank God for your diploma. You can go for a degree. You shall get there. I thank God for your degree. You shall go for a master. You shall get there. Am I talking to somebody here? I thank God for your master. You can go for a PhD. I've come to declare. You shall get there.
You are talking in thousands. Listen. People are talking millions. Can I continue? People are talking in terms of what? Forget your 100,000, 200,000. We are not talking about that anymore. I'm talking to you. Don't settle there. Don't settle in hundreds of thousands. There are millions. And if you are dealing with millions, there are billions. I say there are billions. I've come to prophesy. Don't settle in millions. Go for billions. If you're talking about billions, don't you settle there. Go for trillion. I came to prophesy. You shall get there. I say you shall get.
At Bishop Masinde. You don't know me. My church has got 500 members. Shut up. In this same city, there are churches with 1,000 people. There are churches with 1,000 members. I've come to assure you, tonight, don't settle at 500. Go for 1,000. You shall get there. If you've got 1,000, don't you settle there. Go for 5,000. You shall get there. If you've got 5,000, go for 10,000. You shall get. You shall get.
Na nyumba ya 3 bedrooms.
So I have a 3 bedroom house.
3.
Tatu.
Na choo moja na bafu moja.
With one toilet.
In this same city.
Mji huu.
In this same?
Katika mji huu.
There are people.
Kuna watu.
With houses.
Wana majumba.
6 bedrooms.
Bedroom sita.
Each one of them in suit.
Kila mmoja basi.
I've come to challenge.
Nakuja kukupatia changamoto.
Don't stay in Haran.
Usibaki.
Gonga jirani yako mwambie neighbor.
Mwambie jirani.
Where you are right now.
Pale ulipo sasa.
Is your Haran.
Ni Haran yako.
Refuse.
Kata.
To settle there.
Kubaki pale.
There is a greater place.
Kuna bahali pakubwa.
There is a bigger place.
Kuna bahali pakubwa.
There is a superior place.
Kuna bahali pakubwa.
In God for you.
Inaitwa kwako.
Somebody say amen.
Sema amina.
Amen.
Lakini kuna matatu tatu.
I have three matrices.
Tatu.
Tatu.
In this same city,
katika mji huu,
there are people.
Kuna watu.
With the 20 matatus.
Wana matatu 20.
I've come to assure you.
Now
that you're in this service,
I
said, now that you're in this service, I've come to assure
you,
you shall get there. You shall get. Tell me, I refuse to settle financially where I am. I'm going for more. You settle where you are. That's why you saw your pastor. He was in Mirema. Then he came here. Then he came there. Then he's here. And he has planted all over. We refuse to settle because the results are new there. I've come to declare for this church. Where are you? I've come to declare for this church. And you there. I've come to declare for you. And you there. I've come to declare for your family. And you there. I've come to declare for your business. And you there. Somebody say yes. Somebody say, don't you settle where you are. That's not your dwelling place. Pass through.
Peter.
And go to where God has prepared. At the kind of a table that your enemies cannot stop
you.
Aduizako.
Aduizako.
Hawezi kuzuia kula.
Hawezi kuzuia kula.
Kwa sababu si wao wameandaa hiyo meza. Ni Jehovah amekuandalia.
Yes.
In a place called there, kuna meza umeandaliwa.
Aha.
Kuna kikombe kinachofurika.
Yes.
Umepakwa mafuta tayari.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu sema amina.
Somebody say amen.
Mtu aseme amina.
Touch to your tell him neighbor.
Ame jirani.
You'll be glad you came for this service.
Utafurahia ulikuja katika ibada hii.
Because I came to prophesy
and
establish you. There's a new there for you. Don't settle where you are. You have written one book. Write another one. You shall get there. You have produced one CD. Go for a second CD. You shall get there. You have built one house. Go and build a second one. You shall get there. You have bought one piece of land. Buy another one. You shall get there. You have bought one car. Go for a second one. You shall get there. They said you shall never get married. They didn't know you shall come to this service. I've come to prophesy. You shall get there in the name of Jesus. They said you shall never be a mother. They didn't know you shall come to this service. You shall be a mother. You shall get there. Somebody say yes. Hautabaki kusimamia watu harusi. Hata wewe utasimamiwa. You shall get there. Hautabaki kula keki za harusi ya watu wengine. Utakula ya harusi yako.
Yes.
You shall get
there.
I must close. Because you may think I'm preaching yet I'm finishing. Haran
Harani
was a type of a checkpoint.
Ilikuwa ni pale pa kutazama.
On the way
katika njia
to Canaan.
Kufika Kanani.
If you drive in Kenya,
ukiendesha gari hapa Kenya,
even in America,
hata kule Marekani,
there's sometimes the police will put a checkpoint.
Kuna pale polisi ataweka pale mahali pa kutazama.
When you come to a checkpoint,
ukifika katika checkpoint,
you are not supposed to stay there.
Ufai kubaki pale.
You're supposed to go through.
Unafaa upite.
You may stay there for 2-3 minutes when the policeman is asking you questions.
Akuulize maswali pengine askari.
But when you answer them,
ukishajibu,
you proceed with your journey.
Utaendelea safari yako.
But Tera hit a checkpoint.
Alifika katika checkpoint.
But this checkpoint
na pale
was an evil checkpoint.
Ilikuwa ni checkpoint ya uovu.
Isn't what I'm going to say?
Nasema nasema nini?
It was an ungazetted checkpoint.
Ilikuwa checkpoint ilikuwa kwa gazeti.
The new inspector general of police.
Yule inspector mpya wa polisi.
When he took over the job,
alipachukua kazi,
he cancelled all the police roadblocks.
Alifuta zile checkpoints zote.
And he said, if a police is going to put any checkpoint from now on. It must be gazetted. Now I'm beginning warfare. From now on, I'm doing warfare until we finish. Because there are some of you, the reason you are not moving, you came to an evil checkpoint. And you are stuck there. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 16 verse 8, he says, I will tarry
Nitaishi
Ephesus.
Katika Efeso.
Because
Mana?
Verse 16
sita.
Until Pentecost.
Mbaka Pentecote.
Because
kwa mana?
Verse 9
tisa.
Hey, sorry, 16 verse 9. Don't go ahead of me. For a great
kwana ile
and effective
mlango mkuu
door has opened to me.
Umefunguliwa kwangu.
But there are many adversaries.
Na kuna vizuizi vingi.
Now,
sasa,
I want to take authority.
Nataka nichukue mamlaka.
Let me pray to the for people on this.
Wacha upande huu.
I say I want to take authority.
Nasema nachukua mamlaka sasa.
Over every adversary.
Katika kila vizuizi.
Was raised an evil checkpoint. Hindering your progress.
Katika kuendelea kwako.
I want to take authority right now.
Nichukue mamlaka sasa.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Wacha Yesu Kristo.
Are you ready for this fight?
Uko tayari?
I say, are you ready for this fight? Is there someone ready for warfare? I told you I'm now finishing. Are you ready for warfare? Stand up and just put up one finger, say, my father. I said you put up one finger, say, my father. I did not say you whistle, say, my father. Say, my father, my father, my father. Every evil checkpoint.
Kila checkpoint ya uovu.
Every evil roadblock.
Kila roadblock ya uovu.
In my way.
Katika njia yangu.
To hinder.
Kunizuia.
My progress.
Kuendelea kwangu.
To get there.
Kufika pale.
Tonight.
Usiku wa leo.
Tonight.
Usiku wa leo.
Tonight.
Usiku wa leo.
In the name of Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
Scatter.
Tawanya.
Scatter.
Tawanya.
Scatter.
Tawanya.
Scatter.
Tawanya.
Scatter.
Tawanya.
Scatter.
Tawanya zote.
Scatter.
Tamariza.
Come on, go ahead and give the Lord a hand clap offering. I cancel every evil roadblock. I remove every ungazetted roadblock around your way. It shall not stay any longer. It shall not hinder you any longer. You must get there in Jesus' name. I said you must get there. In the name of Jesus. You are getting. You are getting. You are getting. You are getting. Keep on standing. We are doing spiritual warfare now. I'm not going to fight alone. We're going to fight together with you. So that we can win together. Because I came to tell you. In the name of Jesus. Your business must grow. Your family must go forward. Your finances must multiply. Your health must be improved. Somebody say amen. You are not dying prematurely. I close the mouth of the grave. It shall not have you. You shall live and get there. You'll be glad you came for this service. I said you'll be glad you came for this service. Because from this service, you will know you are not dying in Haran. You are getting to the promised land. You are getting to your place of fulfillment. You are getting to your place of promise. You are getting to your place of provision. You are getting to your place of fulfillment. You are getting to your place of a covenant with God. Somebody say amen. Where you shall experience God as Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Tikenu, Ebenezer, Adonai. Bishop Jimmy,
Askofu Jimmy,
revelation is progressive. And there is a revelation, man of God, that Terah never had. But me and you, we have that revelation. If Terah knew what we know, he would not have died. But because he did not know,
sababu hakuwa anajua,
he died.
Alikufa.
Can I give a revelation?
Nikupatie basi ufunuo.
In Luke chapter 10.
Luka 10.
Don't sit down, verse 17.
Usikae, Luka 10 mstari wa 17.
You can write it down. Luke 10, 17.
Luka 10, 17.
What does it say?
Yasemaje?
You are reading with me? What does it say?
Pamoja, pamoja, inasemaje?
So many kama watu wanajua kusoma kwa furaha. Stop it there. Then the 70 returned with what?
Wakarudi na nini?
The 7 returned with John.
Wakarudi na...
They returned with what?
Wakarudi na nini?
I declare. From this conference, you shall go back to Tanzania with joy. You shall go back to America with joy. You shall go back to your home with joy. From this service tonight, you shall return with joy. You shall go back to work with joy. You shall go back to your college with joy. Somebody say amen. Because the joy of the Lord is man. May you return with joy from this service. Nobody shall leave this service looking like a chicken that has been raided on. You shall square your shoulders. You shall put your chest forward. You shall walk tall because you have got a testimony. I've been to the service and I've heard the word of God. I'm not dying prematurely. I shall get there. Somebody say amen. When you know you shall get there, you shall return with joy. And they had a testimony of a new revelation. Listen to their testimony. Put up that scripture again. Listen to their testimony. Put up that scripture. What does it say? Read from what did they say? Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your I declare. The reason you shall get there, it is because from today you shall know there is no devil, there is no principality that shall hinder you, because every demon, every principality is subject to you. Lift up one finger, say my Father. Are you ready for warfare? Are you ready for warfare? Say my Father. My Father, my Father, my Father. Every demon, every devil, every principality on assignment in my life, in this church, in my business, in my ministry, today, in the name of Jesus, you are going down. You are defeated. Get out. 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 There's no demon that has authority to stop you. You have a new revelation. Even demons are subject to us. Look, they were giving Jesus their testimony. Jesus also gave them his testimony. Listen to what he tells them in the next verse. Look at what he tells them. He's telling them, oh, you saw demons subject to you.
But
he said to them, I
saw
Satan fall like lightning from heaven. I like that testimony. I like that testimony. That's our captain. Tell me about that's our captain. His name is Jesus. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He says, hey, forget these small demons. I've dealt with the big demon. I've dealt with Satan himself. And Satan has fallen. And I'm telling somebody here, in the name of Jesus, no Satan shall hinder you, because Jesus has taken care of him. Somebody tell your neighbor, you shall get there, because Jesus has taken care of Satan. Verse 19. This is one of my favorite scriptures. What does he say now? He says, behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means stop you.
What could we have?
Listen.
Sikiza.
Instead of hurt you, would they stop you? Are you ready?
Uko tayari?
What did he say?
Yasemaje.
Again? Read to your neighbor. Pick a neighbor that you like. Pick a neighbor that you like. And read that to that neighbor. What did Jesus say? Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. And nothing shall by any means stop you. That's why I know nothing shall stop you. There's no power to stop you. The devil cannot stop you. The demon cannot stop you. He doesn't have the power to stop you. That's why I can declare you are getting there. My brother, my sincere apologies. You people in the West don't understand this scripture. We understand it in
Africa.
And I can give you some revelation. You go and preach to them, tell them I've come from the motherland.
Africa.
Put the scripture up again. We understand what Jesus was saying. Because every witch and wizard in
Africa,
they use animals to stop people. They take your money. They put it in a chameleon.
Burukenge.
So the chameleon is going like that to slow your money from increasing. They take your photograph. They put it under a tortoise. So that tortoise, as it's going like that,
it's
supposed to slow your speed. They've taken your underwear and they put a snake to lay eggs on your underwear to stop you from getting children. But today, Jesus says, I give you authority. I give you to do what? To walk over. And I see someone walking over. Walk over. Every snake. Every scorpion. Every chameleon. Every leopard. Every animal. They use in witchcraft. Walk over it. I said walk over it. To trample means as you are going there, you will walk over them. But you are going there. So can I see you walk over them? Every scorpion, every snake, every chameleon, every tortoise, walk over it. One finger, say my father. Say my father. My father. Every animal used in witchcraft. Every snake. Every chameleon. Every scorpion. Every tortoise. Every hyena. Every leopard. Every crab. Being used by witches to hinder me from getting there tonight. In the name of Jesus.
Die.
From tonight, if you get a message, ukipata ujumbe, kutoka kwenu kijijini,
from your village,
kwamba kuna kobe amekufa, tumemuua saa hii.
We have killed the tortoise now.
maombi. From this prayer, tortoises have died. Snakes have died. Leopards have died. Hyenas have died. Chameleons have died. Because you must get there. You must get. And no animal shall hinder you. Praise you. Come on, go ahead. Give one of my coffee, a man. Go ahead, give the Lord a hand clap. Testify. Celebrate.
Shangilia.
And tell your neighbor for me, neighbor. Now I know.
Sasa najua.
My life.
Maisha yangu.
My family.
Familia yangu.
The work of my hands.
Kazi mikono yangu.
My business.
Biashara zangu.
This church.
Kanisa hili.
My ministry.
Huduma yangu.
Will never.
Haitawai.
Ever.
Kamwe.
Be the same again.
Kusalia sawa
tena. Because.
Maana.
I.
Mimi.
Will.
Sita.
Get.
Tafika.
There.
Tafika pale.
Listen to my voice. None of you.
Hakuna aliyesikia sauti yangu.
Hakuna hata mmoja.
Hakuna hata mmoja.
Who has heard my voice.
Aliyesikia sauti yangu.
Shall die prematurely.
Atakufa mapema.
You shall get there. In Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
May you walk.
Wacha utembe.
May you live.
Wacha uishi.
May you operate.
Wacha uendelee.
In the light of the revelation we have received. That in the name of Jesus. You are getting there.
Utafika pale.
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 In Jesus' name.
Kwa jina la Yesu.